With normal voice production, the lungs push air between the vocal cords, causing them to vibrate. In order for vibration to occur, enough air pressure must also develop below the vocal cords. Known as subglottic pressure, there needs to be a match between this pressure and how tightly the vocal cords are positioned together. Vocal problems and fatigue occur when there is a mismatch or imbalance between the subglottic pressure and the vocal cords, which are closed together against this pressure. Vocalization through a thin straw puts the vocal folds in the most optimum position and shape for vibration. This is accomplished by creating pressure above the vocal cords to partially negate the pressure from below. As such, voicing becomes easier with the better position and shape of the vocal folds, especially to help start a clear, easy sound whether the vocal cords are too stiff or whether they are swollen due to inflammation. Furthermore, a strong, clear voice can be sustained for longer periods of time without fatigue. A regular drinking straw can be used at first, but as one gets proficient in these exercises, the goal is to use a 3 to 4 millimeter diameter straw that is 5 inches long. Depending on the vocal issue present, the diameter can also be varied. The more tight or pressed the voice, use a thinner or longer straw. The more breathy the voice, a wider or shorter straw can be used. These straw exercises should be performed several times a day for about 5 minutes. When properly performed, you should feel the voice vibrations around the mouth and lips as well as within the straw itself. Also, the voice should feel like it is centered at the head level instead of the throat or chest. Always breathe in through the nose and out the straw. Never breathe in through the straw. To begin, start by making a single sustained tone at a comfortable pitch that is clear and steady for 1 to 2 minutes. It is important to make sure air is blowing out of the straw when performing these exercises. You can confirm this by feeling for airflow at the end of the straw, or by seeing bubbles if you dip into water. It is very important that there is no air escape around the straw or out the nose. If you pinch and release your nose, the sound should not change. Next, try to perform single pitch sounds alternating with silent pauses, but all while continuously blowing out without variation. If the straw is dipped in water, one should see bubbles continuously without any variation while doing this exercise. Now vocalize little bumps in the sound at a single continuous pitch. Next, perform pitch glides from as low as you can go to as high as you can. Focus on keeping the sound as steady and clear as possible at all times. Now try pitch glides while making little hills. For singers, doing scales through the straw just like you are doing warm-up exercises is beneficial. Finally, try singing a song through the straw. Pick a song that has a lot of different pitch levels. At all times, focus on making sure the abdominal muscles are being used to vocalize instead of the throat. The vocal effort should be the same as if you are making a normal speech sound. After doing these exercises for about 5 to 10 minutes, you will find that when you go back to normal speech without the straw, the voice seems to be coming out of the face and eyes instead of your throat. This phenomenon is called high placement of the voice. Every time you talk, you should strive to maintain this high placement of the voice. After many hours of talking or singing, the high placement of the voice may start to drop down into the throat. The voice will also start to sound pressed. Whenever this happens, perform the straw exercises again to try and reset the voice into the head region.